What's going on, guys? Phil here from Phil's Craft Corner. Today we are making this. This is another mandala that I got sent from Swastik Design Crafts. They sent the file over for me to make a video and it turned out amazing. A lot of you guys have been asking me to paint one of these and I painted this in gold and rose gold, and as you can see, it turned out really, really nice. This is only 5 layers. It's a little bit of a pain to line up because of the steps in these ones. These two in particular were a little bit difficult to line up, but if you have a look at the way they line up, it's quite an even distance between each one and you can just eyeball that. It's not too difficult. Overall, I'm really happy with this design. It was really easy to cut, really nice and simple. It was sent as a DXF for me. It was a little bit bigger than this, but I ran out of large sheets and the supplier couldn't get them to me in time to make this. But I think it's a really nice size. On the back, I put one of these little pitch hanging hooks. I just glued this on just to make sure that the screw wasn't going to pop out and be showing in there. It's not going to take a whole lot of weight anyway. This probably weighs about 200 grams or anything, or something like that. So it's not much at all. I did use 4 sheets of 4mm MDF on this A4 size, because that's what I had left over. So one of each sheet on the back, and then the last two were able to fit onto one sheet on their own. So as you see, that hangs nicely there. That's probably its new home. I did want to start filling up this wall with some of the mandalas that I was cutting. Unfortunately, I knocked over my guitar one, which was stood there for one video. I knocked it off and damaged the front there, which was really unfortunate and I was quite upset about. But it just goes to show that that sticky glue that I use holds really, really well on these. The only reason it damaged down here was because it landed on the skirting board that way after I'd knocked it off, and yeah, I'm quite upset about it. I might remake it at some point. Might try and get it bigger, I don't know, because this was actually the biggest one I've ever made. It's the biggest one that will fit on my machine. So let's head over to the laser, we'll get this cut out and you can just sit and enjoy it. That's it for this design. I hope you like the process of it. I really do like this design. As I said before, it's really simple. It is probably going to live there on my wall, and we can see it in every video, and you can hopefully see this wall grow and build with more and more designs. If you did like this, please hit that thumbs up. Let me know that you did like this, and it helps show my videos to more people, which helps my channel grow. Speaking of which, if you're not subscribed, please do consider subscribing. I'm at 826 subscribers, around that mark right now. So we're so close to getting to that 1,000 subscribers and getting my channel monetized. Once the channel is monetized, all the money that I am making can go back into creating videos for buying files like this and buying new materials just to do more testing and things like that, so I can bring you better content. And if you're feeling really generous, there's a link down below to my Buy Me a Coffee page where you can buy me a coffee, which also helps support the channel. If you don't want to spend any money, then you need some supplies or you want to buy some files like this or anything like that, there are links down below to Amazon where I have some supplies, like the extractor I use for the laser, the lenses that I use for my laser, things like that. If you buy from there, I get a little bit of a kickback and it doesn't cost you anything extra. So if you were going to go and buy something like that anyway, please consider using one of the links in the description. It really helps out my channel. So again, thanks for watching, guys. I will see you in the next video.